Greetings, friends. I am here to tell you a story I first heard in the streets of an enchanted city called Agrabah. It's the story of Aladdin. You can read the tale along with me in your book. It was first told to me by a strange little man who was trying to sell me a lamp. As he started his tale, he threw magic dust into the air, and it made this sound. Now, every time you hear the magic dust sound, it will be a signal that it is time to turn the page. Let us begin the story now. On a starry, moonlit night, a dark figure named Jafar led a shifty thief to a secret cave in the desert. When the magnificent head of a tiger god rose out of the sand and revealed the entrance to the cave, Jafar ordered the thief inside.
Bring me the lamp. The rest of the treasure is yours, but the lamp is mine.
The tiger god stopped the thief.
Know this. Only one whose rags hide a heart that's pure may enter here. The diamond in the rough.
Jafar turned to his parrot companion, Iago.
I must find this one. This diamond in the rough.
Far away in the marketplace of Agrabah, a wiry boy in ragged clothes ran for his life after stealing a loaf of bread. The boy, whose name was Aladdin, escaped with the help of his pet monkey and sidekick, Abu. Sitting on a rooftop with the stale bread, Aladdin looked around sadly at their meager surroundings.
Someday, Abu, things are gonna change. We'll be dressed in robes instead of rags, and be inside a palace looking out, instead of outside looking in.
Nearby, in the garden of the royal palace, the Sultan worried that his daughter, Princess Jasmine, wouldn't like her latest suitor.
Dearest, you've got to stop rejecting every man who comes to call. The law says you must marry a prince by your next birthday.
Jasmine sadly petted her pet tiger, Raja.
Papa, if I do marry, I want it to be for love.
Later that night, with only 3 days left until her next birthday, Jasmine slipped out over the garden wall to escape the pressures of palace life. Unaware that the royal vizier, Jafar, was secretly plotting to take control of the kingdom, the Sultan tried to consult with his advisor about his daughter. But avoiding the Sultan, Jafar retreated to his laboratory to work on his plan. While concocting a spell, a lightning bolt suddenly hit his hourglass and an image of Aladdin appeared. Jafar was surprised to discover that Aladdin was the diamond in the rough, able to enter the cave and retrieve the lamp.
Iago, have the god Razul find this boy and escort him to the palace.
Free at last, Jasmine wandered through her new world, dazzled by the sights and sounds of the marketplace. When she innocently took an apple to feed a hungry boy, the cart owner screamed,
"Thief!"
Unaware that she was a princess, Aladdin rushed in to rescue her.
You're new to the marketplace. Where are you from?
What does it matter? I ran away and I'm not going back.
Suddenly, Razul grabbed Aladdin.
Hey!
Jasmine turned angrily to the palace guard.
Unhand him by order of the princess.
Stunned to learn her true identity, Aladdin could only look back helplessly as Razul, following Jafar's orders, hauled him away. While Jasmine mourned losing Aladdin, Abu found him chained in a dark dungeon, thinking only of her. Jafar, disguised as a prisoner, limped towards Aladdin.
I know where there is a cave, boy, with enough treasure to impress even the lovely princess. I need a young pair of legs and a strong back to go in after it.
I would gladly help, sir, but how do we get out of here?
Jafar moved a stone, and a hidden staircase was revealed. Moments later, they were racing across the desert. Jafar led Aladdin and Abu to the Cave of Wonders. This time, the Tiger God allowed Aladdin to enter. Jafar called in after the boy.
Remember, first bring me the lamp. Then you may touch the treasure, but not before.
Inside, Aladdin and Abu discovered a huge cavern filled with riches.
Would you look at that? Why, just a handful of this stuff would make us richer than the Sultan.
It was difficult for Abu to keep from grabbing the fortune before them. As Abu and Aladdin explored the cave, a golden tasseled carpet came to life and played peekaboo with them.
Look, Abu, a magic carpet.
The carpet floated closer.
Your owner must have come looking for the lamp, too. Do you know where it is?
The carpet zipped off to reveal a huge cavern. The lamp rested at the top of a high stone staircase. While Aladdin climbed, Abu eyed a monkey idol holding a huge jewel nearby. Just as Aladdin reached the lamp, Abu grabbed the jewel. Instantly, the voice of the Tiger God echoed through the chamber.
You have touched the forbidden treasure. Now you shall never again see the light of day.
The cavern shook violently, and the piles of treasure transformed into mountains of fire. Aladdin, Abu, and the carpet scrambled to escape. At the cave entrance, Iago squawked. From above, Jafar reached down to grab Aladdin's hand.
Just give me the lamp!
Jafar clutched the lamp and quickly hid it under his robe. Then he released Aladdin and brushed Abu off his cloak, sending them hurtling back into the cave.
It's mine! It's all mine! With the power of this lamp, I will control the kingdom!
But when Jafar reached back into his robe for the lamp, it was gone. The magic carpet caught the tumbling duo as the cave entrance closed and everything became still. Chattering excitedly, Abu happily revealed the lamp. Aladdin laughed.
Abu, why, you little thief?
Aladdin rubbed some dirt off the lamp to get a better look. Colorful smoke spewed out of the spout, and it took the form of a gigantic genie.
Say, you're a lot smaller than my last master.
Aladdin was stunned.
Wait a minute. I'm your master?
That's right.
Direct from the lamp, right here for your wish fulfillment.
Three wishes to be exact.
Uno, dos, tres.
In a dazzling display, the genie demonstrated his magical powers. Aladdin cleverly tricked the genie into rescuing them from the cave without using up a wish. Then he smiled at his newfound friend.
Genie, if you could have a wish, what would you wish for?
To be my own master. Such a thing would be greater than all the magic and all the treasures in all the world.
I'll do it. I'll set you free. I'll use my third wish to set you free.
The genie was delighted.
Let's make some magic!
What is it you want most?
Well, could you make me a prince?
In a flash, the genie created elegant robes and servants for Aladdin and turned him into Prince Ali. Back at the palace, Jafar and Iago discussed what to do next. Iago got an idea.
Marry the princess, and you become the Sultan!
Jafar thought about it.
The idea has merit.
Excited, he went to see the Sultan. Unrolling an official-looking scroll, Jafar read out loud.
If a princess has not chosen a husband by her next birthday, then the Sultan shall choose for her. And in the event a suitable prince cannot be found, the princess may wed the royal vizier. That's me.
Using his snake-eyed staff to hypnotize the Sultan, Jafar ordered him to arrange the marriage. Dressed as Prince Ali, Aladdin rode triumphantly through the Agrabah Bazaar atop Abu, who had been transformed into an elephant. wearing elegant robes and surrounded by an entourage of dancers, swordsmen, and attendants, he swept through the palace gates. The Sultan greeted him enthusiastically.
Oh, I'm sure Jasmine will like this one.
Jasmine, however, thought her father was trying to marry her off again, and she became angry and stomped off. Aladdin was crestfallen, and the genie offered his wisdom. Following the genie's advice, Aladdin went after the princess. This time, she looked at him more closely.
Wait, have we met before? You remind me of someone I saw in the marketplace.
Jasmine moved to the balcony railing and touched the carpet which kept Aladdin afloat. He smiled.
It's a magic carpet. Would you like to go for a ride?
Hesitantly, Jasmine took Aladdin's hand and stepped onto the carpet. The carpet whisked them off. Slightly startled, Jasmine threw her arms around Aladdin. Below them was a breathtaking view of the palace and the city in the moonlight. During the flight, Jasmine looked more closely at Aladdin.
You are the boy from the market. I knew it. Why did you lie to me?
Aladdin nervously answered.
The truth is, I sometimes dress as a commoner, but I really am a prince.
When the magical tour ended, the carpet zipped back to the palace. Fireworks exploded, and Jasmine reached out for Aladdin's hand. As he helped her onto the balcony, they looked into each other's eyes. Impatient, the carpet bumped Aladdin into a kiss with Jasmine. Aladdin beamed.
Sleep well, princess.
Jasmine looked into his eyes.
Good night, my handsome prince.
Jafar was afraid that his plot to marry Jasmine and become Sultan would be ruined by Aladdin. So he ordered Razul to kidnap the boy and throw him from a high cliff into the water. Nearly drowning, Aladdin feebly reached for the lamp. When the genie appeared, he saw it was no joking matter.
You have to say, genie, I want you to save my life.
Aladdin nodded.
I'll take that as a yes.
The genie granted Aladdin's second wish by using his magic to swiftly take them both to the surface. At the palace, Jasmine rushed happily to see her father.
Oh, Papa, I just had the most wonderful time. I have some good news for you.
The Sultan, still under Jafar's spell, looked at his daughter.
So do I, Jasmine. I have chosen a husband for you. You will wed Jafar.
Jasmine turned angrily to Jafar.
I will never marry you. I choose Prince Ali.
Jafar laughed.
Prince Ali left, like all the others.
Suddenly, Aladdin, still dressed as the prince, appeared in the doorway and exposed Jafar as a traitor. When Aladdin returned to his room, the genie happily popped out of the lamp.
Hail the conquering hero, Aladdin!
You've just won the heart of the princess. What are you going to do next?
The genie waited while Aladdin scowled.
I'm sorry, genie. I can't free you. I can't let Jasmine find out that I'm not really a prince. I need to keep my third wish.
Disappointed, the genie disappeared back into his lamp. Iago flew into the room, and while Aladdin went out to the menagerie, the parrot stole the lamp. Jafar greedily rubbed the stolen lamp. When the genie appeared, Jafar yanked him up close.
I am your master now. Grant my first wish. I wish to be Sultan.
Using his powers, the genie transformed Jafar's clothes into the Sultan's robes. But when Jafar appeared before Aladdin and Jasmine as the Sultan, they refused to obey him. Jafar turned to the genie.
For my second wish, I wish to be the most powerful sorcerer in the world!
The genie nodded sadly and granted the wish. With his sorceress powers, Jafar transformed Aladdin's princely robes back into rags.
Look at your prince now!
Aladdin looked sadly at the princess.
Jasmine, I'm sorry.
Eager to be rid of Aladdin, Jafar trapped the boy and his friends in a tower and zapped it to the ends of the earth. Bewildered, Aladdin crawled out of a snowbank and turned to Abu.
This is all my fault. I should have freed the genie when I had the chance. I'm sorry, I made a mess of everything. I've got to go back and set things right.
Aladdin quickly rescued the carpet from beneath the fallen tower and was swept aboard. Together, they soared up over the clouds back towards Agrabah. Back at the palace, Jafar sat majestically on the throne. Just when it looked like he was about to have everything he wanted, Aladdin reappeared. Jafar knocked Aladdin backwards and zapped Jasmine inside a giant hourglass.
You thought you could outwit the most powerful being on Earth? Without the genie boy,
you're nothing.
Aladdin thought of a strategy to finally be rid of Jafar.
That may be true, but the genie has more power than you'll ever have.
Shocked at the thought, Jafar got an idea.
I'm ready to make my third wish. I wish to be a genie!
Magical energy swirled around Jafar as he was transformed into a genie. Jafar cried out gleefully.
The universe is mine to command!
Aladdin picked up the lamp and smiled.
You wanted to be a genie? You got it! And everything that goes with it.
Suddenly, large gold cuffs clamped onto Jafar's wrists, and a lamp took shape. Jafar reached out and grabbed Iago's feet as they both vanished inside the lamp. The genie laughed and clapped Aladdin on the back. Everything changed by Jafar's magic was restored to normal as the genie hurled the lamp back to the Cave of Wonders with Jafar inside. Aladdin and Jasmine stood on the balcony.
Jasmine, I'm sorry that I lied to you about being a prince.
The genie appeared beside them.
No problem, you still got one wish left.
Just say the word and you're a prince again.
No. It's time I started keeping my promises. Genie, I wish for your freedom.
What?
The cuffs vanished from the stunned genie's wrists. The Sultan smiled.
You've certainly proved your worth to me. I declare that the princess shall marry whomever she deems worthy.
Jasmine leapt into Aladdin's arms.
Aladdin, I choose you.
As Aladdin and Jasmine kissed, a happy genie disappeared into the sky.
Master, you in luck, cause up your sleeves you got a brand of magic never fails. You got some power in your corner now, heavy ammunition in your camp. You got some punch, pizzazz, Yahoo and how. See, all you gotta do is rub that lamp, and I'll say, Mr. Lamster, what will your pleasure be? Let me take your order, jot it down. You ain't never had a friend like me. Life is your restaurant, and I'm your melody.
Come on, whisper what it is you want. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Yes, sir, we pride ourselves on service.
You're the boss, the king, the shah.
Say what you wish, it's yours, true dish. About a little more baklava. As I'm a columnist, try all of column B. I'm in the mood to help you, dude. You ain't never had a friend like me. No, my. No, no.
Their little hands.
Can your friends go? Woo!
Hey, looky here.
You know, friends go abracadabra, let it rip,
and then make the sucker disappear.
So don't you sit there, smack your buggy hide. I'm here to answer all your business there.
You got me bona fide, certified. You got a genie for a child to fail.
I got a power bird to help you out. Do what you wish, I really want to know.
You got a misstep, 3 miles long, no doubt. Well, all you got to do is rub like so.
Mr. Aladdin, sir, have a wish on 2 or 3. I'm on the job,
you big nabob.
You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend like me.
You ain't never had a friend like me.
Well, my friends, that is the end of the story. And you can be sure that everyone, except Jafar and Iago, lived very happily ever after. In fact, it is said that Aladdin's genie still roams free to this very day. But no one knows for sure.